Annyeong, annyeong, annyeonghaseyo. Assalamualaikum everyone. Annyeonghaseyo. So for this video, we'll be sharing with you guys our experiences as a translator and also an interpreter in South Korea. It takes more than just knowing the language to be a good interpreter or translator. Those in the line of work would understand this. You definitely need skills and also a lot of practice to be good at it. Before we start, we realize many people are still confused between the term translation and also interpretation. So here we will unravel it for you. Interpretation and translation are two closely related linguistic disciplines. On the surface, the difference between the two is only the difference in the medium. The interpreter translates orally, while the translator translates written text. For a start, you guys can use this app called YouDictionary, as it has a lot of functions that could be very, very beneficial to you in the long run. I'm pretty sure all of us struggle with grammar sometimes, right? So that's why we all need this grammar check function in the app. You put your sentence in the space provided and they will check your grammar, and if it's incorrect, they will correct it for you. The second function this application called YouDictionary has to offer is the camera translation function. If you're outside and you found a new word or any phrases that you're unfamiliar of, you can just capture it with your phone and let the app translate it for you. It's so easy and it's so convenient because you don't have to do anything, you just have to capture it and all done. The third function, if you're out of data or you have no Wi-Fi connection or internet connection around you at the moment, no worries, no big deal, because this app called YouDictionary has an offline mode as well. Just download the language that you want and you can use it freely outside. The fourth function is the vocabulary game function. I'm pretty sure we all know that vocabularies are very important in picking up a new language, because that's when you know what kind of words to use and when to use them, you know? So with this application, you can learn new words, new vocabularies in your favorite new language while having fun. There's also gonna be some situations where you will need to translate to other languages instead of just Malay or English. So you don't have to worry so much because they have 106 more languages for you to use whenever you need any translation services. So what are you waiting for? There are a lot of other functions that you have to explore in the YouDictionary application right now. Make sure to get it now! A professional qualification, or if you take any interpreting courses or translating courses, then this will definitely help you. In our case, we got in with our topic results that we have taken before. For us, we were really into translation and interpretation during our degree, and we actually started doing this line of work during our second year of degree. We wanted to practice being in the field, in the industry, as we would very much like to know how it's actually like working as a translator and also an interpreter after graduating, as that could be one of our main or side career path depending on the situation. In our first year, before we were even exposed to this experience, we actually took an introduction to interpretation and translation class where we studied about art, history, system, and creativity needed in order to move a sentence, text, or phrase from one language to another. It requires a lot of thinking before actually getting around to it. The reason why it could be very helpful to future translators and also interpreters is that you can use the skills and also the etiquette of how to be one, because one could do rookie mistakes that could be detrimental in some cases. As we all know, translation and interpretation is all about communication and accuracy between two or more parties. If you are not capable of getting the parties to communicate in reaching into an agreement or middle ground, it's not going to be good. You will not be able to get the point across accurately. But it's okay to make mistakes, as you can learn from it. But as time goes by, you should have the realization that this is a professional working scope, and if you are not able to deliver it well, things could get messy afterwards. Another thing to consider being a translator or an interpreter is the emotional toll. Because you are the middleman, if you're inexperienced, you tend to feel that you are the one being interrogated, and you don't want that to happen. It will get personal most of the time. When I first got into this field though, it was hard for me to control my facial expressions. That was during pre-COVID era, where it's permissible if you don't wear a face mask whenever you're out. So I was listening to this statement and I couldn't get myself to agree with this one party. And the first thing I would do is to show expression on my face. Thankfully, I managed to not make it too obvious for everyone in the room to see. But I realized that it's something that I should improve on, because you are the middleman, and so you have to be neutral and unbiased from the start till the end. It helps if you think as yourself as a robot, you know, a machine, helping the two-way communications between the two parties.
The language that we are frequently asked to translate is from Korean to Malay and Malay to Korean, as well as Korean to English and English to Korean whenever necessary. Normally, they would ask for a native speaker of the language to facilitate with the interpretation or translation.
Next, when it comes to difficulties, other than skills and also their experiences, it also comes with the language that you're dealing with. Because you see, Malay and Korean, for example, they have very different word structures. The nearer or the more similar the word structures are, the easier it is to translate or to interpret. For example, Malay has SVO word structure, subject, verb, object. White Korean has SOV word structure, subject, object, verb. Okay, for example, right? In Malay, it will be Abu baca buku. But in Korean, it will be Abu buku baca. It's totally different, you know? That is three words in a sentence. Imagine how twisted it could be if you're required to translate the whole three-line sentences into just one sentence. In that case, it can be really tricky, especially if you're not used to it. Especially when it comes to simultaneous interpretations, where you have to immediately interpret or translate right after the person was speaking or while the person is speaking.
Another point that I think determines the difficulty of translating and also interpreting is the nature of the language itself. Sometimes there's just no equivalent words in both languages, and one simple example would be moshita. Moshita is a Korean word, and according to the Naver Dictionary, it means stylish, wonderful, nice, cool, splendid, lovely, great, fabulous, etc. There's no one word that could accurately represent this word in Malay, so sometimes you have to change the meaning and cater to it according to the context and relevantness to the situation. And as we know, there are just some phrases or words that you can just simply direct translate, so that's one to keep in mind too. After all, it's totally up to the interpreter or translator on how they want to convey the meaning of a certain context.
One thing that we think people always misunderstand about language and literature is that they always think that it's always with you, you know, and it's always there, and therefore it's not respectable or significant enough. But it's not exactly true, as the choice is always yours to pick which words you think suits best, and you have to consider the context, relevantness, and also the situation as well. You always have to revise prospective terms and words related to the case before doing the real interpretation and translation, and it's a continuous process. You learn more along the way, and you will certainly develop more consciousness on the importance of accurate exchange of information.
Another thing is, when you know two or three languages, you tend to mix them up sometimes. So it's really important to only focus on one, so that you could minimize any confusion or misunderstandings. Because in that room, you are the only one reliable, and you don't expect people to understand all those languages as well, right?
But the most important part, if you make mistakes, you have to fix it and further facilitate the communication between the two parties. It's definitely okay to change or add your word, because they know you are giving your best interpretation, and they appreciate that. While mistakes are unavoidable, but it's important to know what to do in order to counter it and use the situation for better interpretation quality. Take your time and always, always be transparent towards the two parties. So it's totally fine to remark, "Hey, I'm further explaining this and this and this, as he doesn't understand this and this and this." It's definitely okay.
So yeah, those are our little experiences of being an interpreter and also a translator here in South Korea. Hope you guys enjoyed today's video. Stay safe at home, take care,
and see you in our next video! Assalamualaikum, bye!
안녕, 안녕, 안녕!